more of a thinking man. You never know.
Jason Manford.
Ladies and gentlemen, scream once you release a small amount of weed for the star of 8 out of 10 Cats, Mr. Jason Manford!
I've done a firm Britain, lost a bit of weight. How are you? Okay?
Good!
Yeah, good! Yeah, I'm glad you're still to see awake and people are drunk at home at this stage as well. That's good. My ideal audience, tired, drunk. That's what I've done there, that's good work. Well, thanks for staring. That makes the job easier, that. Just you lot. Like a fat Michael Owen just wandering on in front of you all. That's all right. We'll be fine. No, I don't know if anyone else has had this worry this year with donating. Obviously, there's a recession on credit crunch. Are we affected by the credit crunch? Has that affected you? A few people, you used to work at Woolworths. I've seen you before. There's nowhere to take that pick and mix knowledge, is there? There's nowhere to take it. The cinema, maybe. But no, I've noticed it. I've noticed a load of industries not doing very well, except one industry doing quite well, the adult sex toy industry. Have you read this in the paper? That the adult sex toy industry, their profits have gone up 26%. In the last quarter. Now, that says to me, there's a lot of people in this country not quite got their priorities right, have they? There's people sat at home going, I am starving, are you starving? I can't afford any food. I'm freezing as well, are you freezing? I can't afford the bills. What are you doing? I'm just going to pop out, get myself a new dildo. You know, like, that says to me the world's gone a little bit mental. So what I've done, right, I've decided to save some money all the way through the year, like I've stopped tipping. That's what I've done. Not fly tipping, I'll always do that. But tipping in restaurants. Have we got people who tip in restaurants? Give us a cheer. Yeah? Who doesn't? Good work. They're my people. I've stopped tipping. I will sometimes tip if the staff have gone above and beyond the call of duty. You know, if they've done something I wasn't expecting, like smiled. Or something, I'll occasionally leave a few bob. But generally, taxi drivers, I've stopped tipping them to the point where if it's £9.80 and I give them a tenner, I'll wait, you know, for that 20p. Tipping has come from America. It's an American tradition because they've got paper $1 bills, haven't they? And it's easy for them. You can give somebody an handful, it feels pretty good. In this country, we've only got a fiver. That's our first paper money. That's too much money to give somebody, I think. Generally, as a tip for nothing. Fiver? I don't pay a fiver for anything that's not electrical. That's just a little system I've got. And the other problem, of course, is you can't give an adult a pound, can you? That's quite embarrassing. You can't give somebody a pound as a tip when he's an adult. You may as well go there, mate. Get yourself some sweets. All right, you can't do it. It's wrong. And I've been on tour lately as well, so I've been staying in a lot of hotels and doing a lot of driving. I'm not very good at driving. I've got this stage where, like a few months ago I was driving, I really needed a wee. I don't know if anyone's been in this situation. I should have had a try before I left home, you know what I mean? And you'll remember having a try, of course. You remember up to being about 10 when your mum's in charge of your bladder? You remember that? Yeah. Having a try. Any time you're going on any journey longer than 15 minutes. Right, we've got to see you, Nana. Go for a wee.
I'm all right, don't need a wee.
We'll just go for a try then. Go and have a try. I don't even know what that means, 5 minutes into any journey. You wish you'd have had a better try. Your mum knows. As it's filling up like a water balloon down there. You're not bothered holding the end of your penis. That's a good little trick, that. I don't know what girls do. I don't know what your options are, really. Can you put your finger on it? I don't know. We've gone too far. It's fine. That'll make it spray like a tap. Listen, Have I lowered the tone? It's okay. I was driving a few months ago, desperate I was, and I really needed a wee, and I spotted an empty Coca-Cola bottle in the passenger footwell, so I thought, hold on a minute, I've weed before, I've driven before. How hard can this be together, right? It's well hard. I don't know if anyone's done it. I started weeing in this bottle. It started to fill up pretty sharpish, a lot quicker than I was expecting. Filling up. I'm going, come on, brain, help us out. And as you know, the brain will often help you out when you're not good enough. He's always there for you with, like, a reflex if you're not quick enough. You know, if you fall over, your brain's like, oh, there's your hand, dickhead. Like, you fix this stuff. Then you go, bloody hell, look, you're on the ball. I was nearly on my face there, brain. Yeah, don't worry about it. Just doing my job on the brain, aren't I? Right, that's your brain helping you out. Sometimes he's not your mate. The brain will do things like, oh, wind you up sometimes. My brain likes to do it just as I'm dropping off to sleep sometimes. He likes to make me make a noise. I don't exactly know what this noise is in the day. I think it's along the lines of this. Where's that noise come from? Sometimes it accompanies it with a little shake of the leg as well. Likes to throw the two together. Then I wake up and then it convinces me it wasn't me who made that noise. There's someone else in the room making noises. I wake up in a panic. Meh! What the bloody hell was that? I'm not a brain man. But I was driving this time, weaning in this bottle, it's filling up. I'm going, come on, brain, help us out. And thank God he did. 550ml on the dot just stopped. I was like, good work, happy days. Put the lid on, threw it out the window. Now, I'm aware that's disgusting, a little bit horrible. The worst thing was that he sat there and he failed me for it, right? And I know. That's right, it's a driving test. You're all right, sir. You'll get it on the way home. I failed my driving test 6 times in total, right? Can anyone beat 6? No, I really need to stop asking that question. Six times in total, right? And it's annoying failing your test. There's stuff in there that shouldn't be in there. Parallel parking. I remember going, Jason, this is the parallel park we're going to do. Can you put your car between that red car and that blue car? I said, no, I can't really. You know, I don't even live there. You know what I mean? When's this going to come in useful? Another one, I was going 35 in a 30 zone. The examiner said, what speed are you doing, Jason? That's the same as you. That was a fail, right? The worst one, though, is I got to a junction. I looked right. I said, all right, your side. Straight fail. What's he sat there for if he's not going to help you out? And my wife, she passed first time, right? And I was very proud of her, but she admitted to me afterwards she'd had a bit of a flirt with the examiner. You know, low-cut top, short skirt, give it, oh, is that the gear stick? You know, proper went for it. The worst thing was, when I did that, that was another fail. So you can't win with these people. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks very much. I'm Jason Manford. Thank you. Bye-bye. Okay. Thank you.